Okay, buddy.
And I can't wait so we can break apart the hit me if I seem a little unimpressed with this, an antisocial pessimist.
Okay, so Everest is a 90-minute wait. I'm not waiting that long, and single riders is probably gonna be super long. So I just got a fast pass for one of the dinosaur rides, the little one that we saw earlier. It was like a short kid ride, so I just got it. So let's go do that really quick, and that'll be our last ride, and then we can move on to Epcot. All right, we're here. This is the ride we're going on. Let's do it. That was a fun ride. A little bit bumpy. It seems not like, it seems very old, so it was very like bumpy, and you're rocking like all over the place, but you know, it was a good ride. That will do it with Animal Kingdom. That is three rides. Epcot's gonna be quite something, because we don't got that much time. We have until 11 p.m. It's currently like 6 o'clock, 5:30 or something like that, so I gotta do Epcot really quick. Probably do all shows, to be honest, with Epcot, because Epcot, all the rides are like pretty long. I looked at the wait time and they're pretty long, so looks like we're gonna do probably all shows with this. So yeah, let's go to Epcot. Also, it rained about for it only rained for like 10 minutes, so I didn't get wet at all. It was like sprinkling, so that's good. So the sun's out for the rest of the day. So that bus ride was, there's at least 50 people on that bus ride. That's a bus took a while. Surprisingly, I'm still kind of early for that fast pass, but I believe you can get on the ride like 10 minutes or 15 minutes earlier, so I'm good. I'll just go through the security check here, get in the park, and then walk straight into the ride right there in Epcot. So that bus ride killed me though. That like hurt my feet a lot. There was a lot of people. We were all close together. It was a big mess, but hopefully the bus going to Magic Kingdom, hopefully it's better. And yeah, so also I forgot to mention that I made a fast pass for the Finding Nemo ride. So it was like the only one that was available as of right now. So I made that back in Animal Kingdom, so we're looking pretty good so far. I think it's about 6 o'clock on the dot, actually. Or maybe 6:10, something like that, so I think we're doing pretty good, so looks like this challenge is, I think I'm gonna complete it. And towards the night, everyone starts to leave, so all the rides in, like, Magic Kingdom will be, like, really short, so. Anyways, here we are at Epcot.
There it is, Epcot.
Let's check out the wait time for Spaceship Earth. It's a 35 minute wait. Not bad, not bad. We're not gonna go on this unless I get a fast pass, but I might. I don't know, I'm not sure yet. Here we are. The Seas with Nemo and friends. Nemo, where are you hiding? This is a nice relaxing ride. I'm sitting down.
Nemo!
What do you mean? He's right there.
Oh,
no,
Nemo!
Where?
No,
that's why we're trying to find
him.
Find
who?
Oh, Nemo! Where are you, Nemo?
Who's Nemo?
He's my son. You know that.
I do.
We went on a huge adventure together.
Oh my. Dory's me.
Totally stopped. Well, Coo-coo-ca-choo, here's what you do. Stay in your seats while the Crush Man sees what he can do to get you moving again in the big old blue.
Are you kidding? The ride always stops on this. Every time I ride this, the ride always stops.
Righteous! Righteous!
Totally! But everybody's looking for you.
Totally, dude.
So many cool.
to the Soarin' building. Or actually, it's not called the Soarin' building. I forgot what building it's called, but the Living with the Land is on this ride. It's a 10-minute wait, so might as well do it. Living with the Land, a 10-minute wait. Looks like it's getting a little bit longer, but it'll be a short wait. There's no wait at all. Literally, we get around right here.
Welcome to Living with the Land. As you board the boat, please lower your head and watch your step.
You have the whole row to myself.
In the desert, nature has created a very different, no less beautiful living system. And while this arid landscape may seem lifeless, it is very much alive. The American prairie once appeared as desolate as the desert, but over time, rainwater and nutrients gradually penetrated the hard surface of this land. Even the hooves of the mighty buffalo helped create the rich soil that one day become home to the American farm.
That's the same dog from Carousel of Progress.
We can enrich the soil without the use of chemicals. In Saudi Arabia and Mexico, we're learning to produce food on desert seacoasts by developing and planting crops that thrive on saltwater.
Welcome to our living laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce bountiful harvests now and into the future. When we mention farming, you probably don't think of fish, but fish farming, or aquaculture, accounts for nearly half of all the seafood consumed globally. Tilapia, bass, and catfish, like the ones you see here, are three of the more profitable crops raised by fish farmers. The sustainable system we're using here recycles the water in the tanks. As a result, we're able to save millions of gallons each year. Our small fish farm produces nearly 5,000 pounds of fish each year to serve in restaurants around Walt Disney World. That the aquaponics system on your left combines hydroponics with aquaculture. The fish provide a natural source of fertilizer for the plants, and the plants help keep the water clean for the fish. It's another great way to produce more while using less.
That was a good calm ride. We did two already. We haven't been in this park for an hour and we've done two already, so I can easily do a third ride and just be done and go to Magic Kingdom, but I want to do at least like an intense ride. So I think I'm going to do Mission Space next. I'm not sure. I'm trying to see if there's any fast passes open. Look at that. Right behind Mission Space is the moon. Can you see that? Yeah, you can see the slither of the moon. That's really cool. Man, it's a full moon. Alright, let's do this ride. It's only 25 minutes, so it shouldn't be that bad of a week, I think. I don't know. Let's see how this goes. Oh, it dropped down to 20 minutes? Wait. I think we might do the shorter way just because I want to get everything in.
International Space Training Center.
So that Mission Space ride, if you didn't know, there's two things you can do. There's two attractions in the ride, but they're both basically the same thing. You can do the intense version or the easy version. I didn't know there was two different like rides, I guess I should say. Well, it's a different like video. The intense training has you going to Mars, and then the basic training, which is the one I did, I wanted to try it and it was a low wait time. It was traveling around the Earth. So I didn't know that was different, but it was a good ride overall. So we've done three rides already, so let's go to Magic Kingdom. Maybe we can get the fireworks, we can see them. And we can hang out for the rest of the night. I think I have like 3 hours at the park, so maybe four. I'm not sure what time it is, but I'll have a decent amount of time to look at all the stuff, and we can go on some rides. And that has I looked at the Fast Pass for Magic Kingdom, and there's a lot of cool rides that I can do, so. 3 parks down, 1 park to go, and we have a lot of time. So overall, this is a pretty successful day, I would say. It's not over yet. We still got 1 more park, and it's my favorite one. The best one for last. Goodbye, Epcot. I'll see you soon. On to the Magic Kingdom. Okay, so it's 9 minutes until the fireworks show at Magic Kingdom. There's no way I'm making it, so maybe we'll catch a glimpse of it, but I don't think so. So it all depends on this bus right here. If it's here or if I have to wait, then there's no way I'm seeing it. And I think it's a pretty far drive, so I don't think we'll be able to see it, but at least we'll go on some rides, so we'll be good. Okay, so I'm having the first issue with going to the Magic Kingdom. Usually I would go to the bus, but there's no bus saying to go to the Magic Kingdom. I don't know if it's because it's late, but it says I have to take the monorail, so I have to find how to get up here. I don't know how to get up there, so I have to find a way, and then we take that to the Magic Kingdom. I was looking for something that I couldn't find. It's a feeling you give me inside. Let's go to the Magic Kingdom.